As we gather today here in peace and safety in this quiet chamber, we must remember that there is a city half a world away that is struggling to survive. A city that is fighting for human rights and human liberty. A city that is a solitary pinpoint of light on a continent of authoritarianism. A city called Hong Kong. And the need there is urgent, and the hour there is late, and it is time for America to act. And I know this because I've been there. I've been there myself. I have seen it, Mr. President. I have been to Hong Kong. I have been to the streets of Hong Kong. I have seen the protesters marching in support of, in defense of their basic human rights. I have seen them demonstrating for their basic human liberties. I have seen them confronting the police with their tactics of brutality and oppression. And it makes me think, Mr. President, that sometimes in the course of history, the fate of one city defines the challenge of an entire generation. 50 years ago, that city was Berlin. Today, that city is Hong Kong. And the situation there is critical because Hong Kong is sliding towards becoming a police state. Make no mistake, Beijing wants to impose its will on Hong Kong. It wants to silence dissent in Hong Kong. It wants to steamroll Hong Kong, just as it wants to steamroll all of its neighbors in the region, just as it wants to control the region, and just as it wants ultimately to control the entire international system. And we know what's at stake in this country because we've gotten all too familiar with Beijing's tactics. We've seen what Beijing has tried to do to this country for decades now. They have stolen our jobs. They have stolen our technologies. They have tried to build and are building their military on the backs of our middle class. And their aims are expansionist. And their aims are domination. And their aims are not compatible with the security or the prosperity of this country. And that's why what is happening in Hong Kong today is so important. And the fight there is so significant. Will a totalitarian China, totalitarian Beijing, will they be allowed to dominate the city of Hong Kong, to silence it, and then to turn to the region as a whole? You know, let's review what's actually happening there in the streets of Hong Kong. This didn't start with the people of Hong Kong. This started with Beijing. This started with Beijing and its puppet government, its puppet chief executive in Hong Kong, attempting to revoke the rights of Hong Kongers, the rights, by the way, that Beijing promised to the people of that city in 1984 and again in 1997, trying to revoke those rights by bringing in a bill for extradition of Hong Kong citizens and Hong Kong residents to mainland China to be tried in China's courts where there is no due process, where there are no basic guaranteed liberties, where there is no recourse. This was Beijing's plan, and that would have affected not just the citizens of Hong Kong, but the residents there, including over 80,000 Americans who are currently residents in the city. And the people of Hong Kong,